grateful I am. I'm very grateful for this. Whatever that you have done with your support, your prayers, I want to show my appreciation that I'm very happy for this. And I can't mention the names. 1,000 people is a lot. So I want to thank everyone who helped me in this journey. So with this, we are going to design a simple birthday flyer to appreciate or show my appreciation for what you have done for me. Alright, sorry for the delay. So we are going to design a church flyer to celebrate this day. I'm very, very happy for this. So without further ado, let's jump right into Photoshop. So with your Photoshop open, go to File, New. Then a new document is going to open for you. Then under the preset details, I'm going to, let's say, 1,000 subscribers. Celebration. And I will leave the width and the height 600 by 600, and I will maintain 300 resolution. Then from here, click on create. So a new document is going to open for us. Then I'll click on the D to set my foreground to black. Then with the help of my pen, with the help of my paint bucket tool, I think the shortcut is G, I'm going to set the foreground or set the background all black. Then I'm going to look for an image that I'm going to use for this project. So let me open my document and let's see what image that I'll be using for this. So let me go to my downloads, and please, immediately I finish this video, I'm going to share with you the resources that I'm going to use in the description box for you guys to download. So let's see. Alright, so there is this flyer that I saw that is very good, and it's a program that is coming on at Kumasi, and I really love how they designed this flyer. So I want to go with you the process that they went through to design this. So I think I have downloaded some of the resources that they use. So I have some of the pictures and stuff here. So let's see how we can design this same thing. So with this, then we will change the size to A3. So Control N, then under print, we are going to select A3, and then I think they started by making a rectangle shape. So they drew a long rectangle like this. So let's go back and look at what they did. So you see that they started with a rectangle shape. Then let me make it a little bit smaller. All right and Control A to select the whole document, or you can go to select and select all. Then I'm going to align this to the center, and Control D, or go to select and deselect the selection. Then from here, I'm going to distort this image. I'm going to distort this rectangle. You see that with this one, they distort this shape. So I'm going to do the same thing. Control T for the free transform. And then I'll right click and let's say distort. So I'm going to push this one up to get the size or how how their own turned out. So you see that their own here went up a little. All right, then when you are satisfied, click on enter or the mark over here to accept changes. Then we are going to add another one by Control J to duplicate. Just duplicate one, and with that one we are going to just turn it around a bit. Then I'll move it a little up, and then I'm going to click on the mark to accept changes. Then from here I'll change here to red, and you see that this layer is on top, so I'm going to bring that one down. And let me change the color of this. I think they use a brown type of color, so let me use a deep brown like this. Let me see whether that's the color they use. So the color was more deeper, so let me try to get the color they used. All right, so you can see that we are on course, and let me move this one over here. So their own was something like this. So then let me move this one inside a bit, and I can raise this one up. All right, so from here let's try to bring the man of God or the logo of the church. So I think I have the logo. All right, so I'm going to use this image for the man of God. I tried downloading the image, but I couldn't see the image, so I'm going to use my own image, or I'm going to use an image that I found about. I'm going to use an image that I found around this. So this was the image that I found. It's the same man of God. So first of all, we are going to make a selection around the image. And you know, anytime that you are trying to design something, making a perfect selection is an ideal, because without a perfect selection, your design is going to be ruled out. All right, so you see that this one is what we are going to use. So with the help of my pen tool, where is it? Here is the pen tool. Then I'll zoom in, and to zoom in using Photoshop is very simple. You can hold down the Alt key on your keyboard and use your scroll bar on your mouse to zoom in, or you can simply click on the Control or Command on a Mac plus the plus sign on the keyboard. You see that we have the plus and the minus sign. So when you click on Control plus the plus, you zoom in, and when you click on Control minus, you zoom out. So with this, I'm going to start making my selection. So to make your selection with a pen tool, you click and you drag. You don't click and leave. You click and drag, then you make a point, click and drag to make another point again. And also you can break the handle. I think I have a video on how to use the pen tool, but I made a video about it, but I couldn't edit it to upload. So I think I'll make another video about how to use the pen tool, because the pen tool is a very interesting tool. When you know how to use it, it's going to make a lot of your work easier. And guys, I would like to announce to you that in few weeks time, I'll be announcing a launch. I'm launching a program, or I'm launching a course on Skillshare. So if you are not on Skillshare, please don't miss out, because this one is going to be massive. I'm going to show you the process where I went through to design this whole book. It's a funeral brochure that I did for my auntie. So you can see the back, you can see the first page. So I have it here. Let me show it to you guys to know what I'm talking about. So I think it's somewhere here. Sorry guys for wasting your time. I just want you guys to know what I'm doing or what I am up to. That's the reason why I haven't been able to upload many content as I should be doing. So this is the whole book that I want to show to you guys. Here is it. So all right, let me show you the video part. So I don't want you guys to miss out from this because this one is going to be massive. I have already recorded some part of the video. I'm not done yet. When I'm done, it left with the editing. It left with the editing part, and that part is very crucial. It's very difficult to edit videos. You know, editing videos is very headache thing. So that I'm giving myself like 2 weeks to be done with this project so that I'll share with all of you guys so that you actually know what I'm talking about. So this is the funeral brochure that I want to go through with you. But it's not only this, it's a whole design from the 1 week, the funeral poster, the invitation card. We printed some on a key holder, on a handkerchief, on a mug. So there are so many things that I want to show with you. So I don't want you to miss out from this because this one is going to be massive. This one is going to be massive. So please make sure you create an account on Skillshare. I'll be leaving a link in the description below. So please make sure after this video you come back, click on the link. I already have a course over there, and the course is booming. People are loving it. It's only one course, but the way people are loving it, I'm even surprised. So I want you guys to go and check it out. And in 2 weeks' time, I promise you guys that this video is going to be ready for you guys. So you see, this is some of the designs, and I'll be going through with you all the process that I went through to design. You see the funeral brochure. Here is the inside, the pages, how to arrange them, and how you are going to print it, how to save it. Like, I'm going to go through everything with you, so I don't want anyone to miss out. This is the funeral poster that we did. So here is the funeral poster, funeral receipt, funeral chit. So this course is going to be massive. This course is going to be massive. So here is the picture frame. The picture frame, I didn't do it, but we edited the picture and someone did, and I appreciate the person who did because he did it very nice. Here is the funeral invitation card. Here is the banner. So you see that this one is a big program that I want you guys to come and join us so that we all benefit from this. All right. So let's continue with our project. So we were looking at how to make a selection using the pen tool. And like I said earlier, using the pen tool is a really massive thing. So if you're a graphic designer and you don't know how to use the pen tool, then you are missing out brutally. But let me quickly show you how I do this. So as I said earlier, once you start, what you need to understand or what you need to get is to how to control the path. So you know the blue lines means, like it's a path which at the end of the day we are going to cut this place, the place that I'm selecting. So with a path, you will click and you drag, then so you can, the path is something that you can change the position, the velocity, like I don't know the things that I want to use it for. I want to use for this, but you can click and you drag and you change the position, and you see it has handles. The handles just do not just come unless you click and you drag, and when anytime that you wish to make adjustments to a handle, just hold down the Alt key on your keyboard or Option on the Mac, and you see that it changes from the pen to something like a V shape. Then it means that we can drag over this, we can take it and remove it to where we want it to be. So then I'll align it to the edge of the image. Then I'm going to do the same thing over here. So I will not leave my mouse. So then I will drag. Then if I see that this place I left some parts, I'll hold down my Alt, then I'll drag this place also. So you click, and anytime, and also we can break the handle by holding down the Alt key. Then you come to the middle of the handle. So you see here is an edge, here is an edge, but this is the middle here. So when you come here and you click it, it's going to break the last handle. And you don't need to do it closely, you can also do it far apart. When you master how to use the pen tool, you can do it far apart, especially where the clothes are. You don't need, it's only the hair that when I'm doing, I take a very good care, so that any slight mistake that I make drawing cutting around the hair is going to make the whole thing bizarre, and I don't want it that way. So let me see where I have reached. So I think a place like this is okay, so I don't want to go further again. So let me end this place, and so that I can quickly go to the top. So you just click, hold and drag, and you see that it is making the selection for you. And by the way, this is not only the tool that you can use to make selection, but in my opinion, or in many of the graphic designers' opinion, this is the best tool to use, because some of the images that we work on are not sharp, or they are not crispy as they should be. Most people don't take pictures with maybe a better phone, or at times they take it with a better phone, but when they are sending it to you, they send to you as a, just on WhatsApp, they send to you as a raw image without protecting the document. So when it comes, normally it loses its content. So and using the other way of mixed selection, if the image is not crispy, if it's not sharp and it's not focused, or the background, if the background is interacting with the image, like for instance this image that we are working on, the background and the image and the attire that the pastor is wearing is almost the same. So if you don't take care, you see that you are using the other way of cutting around an image, you see that you'll be entering into the part that you want, part of the image that you want, you really want it to be part. So you want to try and avoid all those mistakes, all those tiny mistakes that you might come across. So we are about to end this. And also, one thing that I would like you to know is that you see that this place, if you didn't select a proper edge, like the edge where you pointed is not where you are supposed to point, you can hold down the Control key on your keyboard, and then with the help of your mouse, you drag into the place that you want it to be. Then with this, let me break the handle to be free, and I can end peacefully. Then from here, what I would like to do is that I can just click on make a selection or right click and say make a selection. The same thing. One thing about Photoshop is that they have given so many options that it performs the same thing. Like for instance, when I come to this place, all right, let me finish with this before I do anything else. So with my selection made, one thing that I can do is to Control J to duplicate, and you see that it duplicate the image for me with only the place that I selected. All right, like I was saying that in Photoshop there are so many ways you can do something, but you achieve the same result. So with this one, Control J to duplicate will give you the same, will give you that option. Or you can go to edit, Control C, or just copy and you go to edit and you paste, just paste, and you see that one too, you get the same result. All right, undo. All right, so this one is okay. So you see that is you either use the Control C to copy, Control V to paste, or you just do it straight, Control J to duplicate, and you are good to go. So that is how Photoshop was made to do many things at a time, at once. All right, so basically what I'm doing here is that I'm using the free control. You see that you have the free control or free transform, and then click on it and you see that, and shortcut is Control T. You see that you have these edges around your image. What that means is that I can hover over the edge, then I can increase the size of the image, but I'm holding the Alt so that I will drag it from the center of where it is placed and it comes outwards. So I think the pasta was placed somewhere here. Let's look at this. All right, so even part of the image was cut off, so let's try to duplicate the same thing. So I think this was how it was. Yeah, let me close this one. All right, so from here what we are going to do is that let me make the image a bit larger. So from here I'm going to type in, or let me finish completing the background. So the background, they downloaded something, like they use something, a weird thing, I don't really know, but I think crucify Jesus or something. Crucifixion. So let's see, I think they use something like this. So I searched for, or I googled crucify Jesus Christ, and let's see the image, crucify Jesus Christ with blood. All right, so I think they use something like this. So anytime that you are searching something on Google image, you make sure that you search around, you type what's in your head, like around what you want to download, and I know definitely you are going to get something similar to what you Google for. All right, so let's try copy, and let me come and paste this one in. All right, so I'll zoom this one, and then let me drag it behind this image. Then I don't want this thing are the portions. So let me select the portion that I want. Control G to duplicate. But make sure the layer is selected. So duplicate and I'll delete that one beneath. Then from here with my image selected, let me do like multiply, or let me go through the blending mode and see. I think something like this is okay. And let me reduce the opacity to maybe 60%. Then I will add a layer mask, and then I'll pick up my brush tool. Shortcut is B, and make sure you see that here is white, so we need to paint with black. So make sure your foreground color is black, and then we are going to blend this one in. Then boom, we get something similar to what they done here. I don't really know what they use, but at least we are on course for now. Then I would like to get their logo. So I don't know how to get their logo, so let me just bring this image here, and I'm just going to use my rectangular marquee tool to select the logo alone. Then Control J to duplicate, and then I'll move this one over here. Then let me zoom in. Control plus to zoom in. All right, then from here I think I'm done with this, so let me close this. I don't want to save. Then it says evangelism for kingdom living. Evangelism for kingdom living. So I'll type the church name. Evangelism for kingdom Evangelism for kingdom living. And guys, I'm planning of maybe every month a poster or a flyer that I will see that is appealing to me like this one. I will come bring it, show it to you guys, and we will all go together and see how we can go about that same design. Because mainly with Photoshop, or when you are trying to learn, practice will make you perfect. So I want to do that to encourage you guys that you should continue practicing, because we that we know a little, we are still learning. Because I know that I don't know anything, I haven't reached anywhere, and there are more room for improvement. I want to improve where I am not happy. So I don't think you two are happy with where you are. And once again, guys, thank you very much for all your support since day one. I'm going to use OpenSant. So this is a phone that is becoming something that I can't go without. OpenSant and sometimes RecSans. At first, I used to use this font, what is it called, Area, but since I met Open Sans, I have stopped using that font because I think this one is cool and it helped me in many of my projects. All right, then I think they wrote this thing also in. And by the way, I'm using the latest version of Adobe Photoshop. This is 2022. You can see it from here, Adobe Photoshop 2022. And if you guys want to download it, I'll leave a link in the description below to download it for free. And also, guys, if you want to buy anything from Jumia, I have an affiliate link. When you buy, your guy is going to get something small. So if, let's see, if you buy something like 30 CDs, maybe they might give me 2 CD or 1 CD to buy credit. Charlie, we need credit too. We need credit. So I don't know if you people buy some for me. We need credit to continue doing the work, because Charlie, uploading, uploading and stuff, it's not easy. So I'll leave Jumia affiliate link in the description below. So anytime you guys use my link to buy something, like maybe you buy a phone, you buy t-shirts, like anything that you buy at all, your boy Pastole is going to get something. And also, if you want to grab me a copy, I think I have a link in the description below which will lead you to that. And also, guys, I have a WhatsApp platform, and in no time I'm going to create a Telegram platform where we can, all of us can come together on one page, and apart from YouTube, we can still be in touch. But the WhatsApp platform is already there, so I want you guys to pick my number in the description box, or let me just mention to you, 0544545496. Join me on WhatsApp, say hi from maybe, you mention your name and you say maybe you are from YouTube and you want to be added to the graphic design group, and quickly you'll be added. So I want to see you guys over there. So please make sure you pick the number again, 0544545496, and let's see what we can all bring together to achieve something great. All right, so we need to type this in conjunction with Kumasi Council. So the program is happening live in Kumasi. Please, sorry for the noise at the back. The program is happening live in Kumasi. I think it's from 24th to 26th. A 3-day program, I think so. And I know you guys shouldn't miss out. If you are only in Kumasi, or even if you are not in Kumasi and you want to come, please come, because this program is going to be powerful. You see the ministers that they are coming. Hey! And I'm a good day inside, though, Charlie. This one, dear, I go some. We go taps. We are going to tap the gray some, Charlie. We are not going to make only all the. We are not going to allow only all the ladies to go and touch you. To get the anointing and stuff, oh, Charlie. 2022, dear. We all make what. You make word pass cry. So Charlie, make sure you don't miss out from this program. So you see that they align this. So let's try to, we are doing the same thing like they did. So, and they gave this one a blue color or something. So let me select that. So select this one. I'll hold down the shift key and I'll select the other one. And I have my character too. Some people don't have it. If you don't have it, no worries, go to window and you will see character. Click on that, it's going to open at somewhere for you. Then you can change the color to the deep blue that they use. All right, and the same thing, you can change this one by clicking on the maybe the test tool, and you have the color option at the top, and maybe you select the color that you want. You see that it changed. So in Photoshop, they have so many ways of applying the same thing. I don't know what's wrong with them. The options are too many to do the same task. All right, so let's align this. So for me to align this perfectly, I'll select both of them. holding the shift key, and you will see that if you are not on the move to, you are not going to get the options that I'm talking about. Make sure you are on the move to. Shortcut is VIN. You see that VIN, and you will see options like giving you this thing. So this one will help you align to the left side for you. All right. Okay. So that is it for the top. Let's see what again they did. So let's try to write dry bone back to life. Dry bone back to life. And also you see that they have the ministers, they have the other pastors who are on board. So let's leave a point. So I think it is 2 boxes, Charlie. This thing is not going to go there. Hey, small place, Penny. Yeah, well, okay, let me try and type this one. So it says dry bone . Hey, see what I'm typing on? I can't spell bones. Dry bones back to life. I think back to life. Okay. Then with my character to open, I'm going to make this one larger, and then I'll open up the spacing. So let me go like 50, let me go like 120, because I'm going to still increase this to maybe 150. Hey, see my own. Okay. So you see that they made this one a little smaller. So I'll go for maybe 100 for this one. And then the bones, they highlighted this one too. Let me give it a highlight of maybe extra bold. And then the back, I'll maintain the same size as the, so that one was 100. Then back to life. So I think this was typing small case, and I'm going to make this one caps. All right. Then there are too much space, so I reduce the spacing. So this is what we use to toggle with the spacing. So let's go for negative like 110, and you see that they are almost close. And I'll change this one to white. I think that is the color they used. Okay. All right, so I'll still like to bring this one back, and let me leave this one at 0. And I think the dry too, I can leave this one also at 0, but the rest, let me maintain this same. But you see that because of the attar, we can't really differentiate that. So let me change this one. I think they turn this one into black and white, so let me choose new adjustment and apply a black and white to this. But the black and white, I'm going to let it affect only this one. So I'll click on creeping mask, create a creeping mask, and because the attar is black and the attar is white, we can still see our test. So what I will do to make it appear is I'll add a shadow. A shadow always works. All right, so with a shadow, then let me bring the distance back and let me increase the opacity. All right, maybe 100%. Bring this one also back. Let me make this one big, like 95. The speed makes the blacks more black. So you see what the speed is, that it makes it more black, but we don't want it more black like that. And the distance, okay, let's bring it down a little. So let's choose like 10. This one is okay, but you can see there are too much spaces here. Why this? Let me close the spaces and let me make the back a little larger. Let me go for, let's see, 120. Yeah, something like this is okay. And close the gap. The gap is too much. Hey, it seems I have come back. Oh, Charlie, the settings that I did, I make loss. So, hey, Charlie, this one there, yeah, well. Okay. And guys, please remember to save your work. Cool. Anytime that you are designing something, please remember to save your work, because it's also a keynote in Ghana, because the light can go off at any time. So let me save it before I continue. Save as, any of them will work. So 1K celebration design. All right, then let me choose desktop, click on save. All right, so from here, let's see what they did again. So, and they did this effect. They change the, first of all, change the font to a different font. So let me see, this font is not going to work. Let me open it over here and see the font. So, and also, if you don't know how to download or install fonts, new fonts, you guys will let me know. It's a very simple thing. So, and as a graphic designer, you should know many things, because sometimes it's going to be headache. But Charlie, we don't have a choice. You don't have much choice. Then let me leave more space. You see that it is like too close. Let me leave it even at zero. Okay. Then I'm going to select my elliptical marquee to ellipse tool. Then I'm going to draw an ellipse. I don't want any stroke. I can see there are strokes over here. Then I think I want white. And I'm going to drag this over this. Let me choose a different color, like gray for now, and see where I am. Then I'll bring this one beneath the dry bone, something. All right, so from here, I think it's perfectly aligned, but let me reduce its size. Okay, so from here, you see that cut inside the shape or the ellipse that they drew. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to select I'm going to first of all make a duplicate of this the test. So I have made a duplicate, you can see there is it, and I'm going to only delete everything, and I'll maintain only the two. So let me bring this one over here. All right, so from here, let me delete the one over here. I'm not going to use it anymore. So you can see this one is on a separate layer now, and this is the ellipse too. So from here, I'm going to select the test. I'll hold down the control or command key. Then I'm going to make a selection around the test. And then with the selection made, I'll select my ellipse tool. Then I'll add a mask to that. So you can see it has hided the circle where we want. So Control I to invert that. And then turn off the visibility, the eyeball over here. And you see that we are going to get a background. All right, so this is how they got that simple effect, you see. All right, but I don't think the positioning is okay, so let me bring it in. I think it's okay now. It is straight line, and you see that this one is not distractive. When I hold down the shift key and I click on this to hide, you see that we have the full ellipse too, so we can change the color to back to white. And I can see there are shadow over there, so let me bring the dry bone beneath this. Okay, all right, so you can see we are on our way, we are almost there. And I think they made this thing. That's very nice. That's very good from them. So I'll make a duplicate again, and then let me delete everything and leave the E. Delete everything, and then I'm going to change the E to this. And then you see that I have the drop shadow. Then I'll take, you see the FX, I can drag and drop this into the bin so that I will not have anything again. You see, I have deleted something. I don't want to delete anything, no. Please, so because of the shadow, I might need this, so let me go for it back. Hey, Yawa deal. Alright, let me drag and drop so that I can get this one. And I noticed that you can make this one larger, so they did something like that. And to get the cool effect that they have here, it's a very simple thing. You can use your brush tool. So select your brush, then create a new layer, and we are going to select an orange type of color like this. Then you click once on your document, resize it, and boom, put it over here. And you are going to get this effect, but I think you can change the blending mode to see how it will blend with other. So I think something, let's go through the blending mode and see which one will do the magic. So I think overlay does the work, but you kind of see that it's not too much. So Control J to duplicate it more. So let me delete this one. It seems like too much. I didn't hear it too much. Delete one more time. Delete one more time. All right. So this is how very simple you can get that effect that they got. All right. But you can see their color is a little bit different. But we can still get that. You can use the hue and saturation, but you creep it to only this layer. And maybe you toggle with the lights, or you can just go through the hue and saturation and see the color that they use. It's like a little purple or something like this. Okay, I think something like this is okay. All right, so I hope you get the idea of how they came about that. All right, so from here, there is nothing much serious left. We are almost through. So let's have the date. It start from 24th, 25th, 26th. And then I'm going to make this one, let's say 80. Hey, 80 is too small. 110. Then position it. And we are going to use this same blue that we use. So click on eye, or look for your eyedropper tool and click on this to sample the color for us, and then select that, and you are going to get the color. And you see that the blue is not popping as it should, so we are going to add a stroke, a white stroke of course, and we can increase this. But you can see I have my position inside, bring it outside, and then you can bring it out. All right, so let's maintain something like 40 and let's see the results. I'm loving it. Wow. Then the spacing is too much, so let me leave it at 90. Okay, so from there I think they added the November Kumasi Sports Stadium Heroes Park. Then let me bring this one to 100, and then let's see what we can do. So grab your rectangle tool, and then no stroke, but this time we want a red color, and test tool November. Let's see what they did. November 21. I think they choose a white color. Then let me change the size. So the size, let's use something smaller. And also I want this one to be in caps, so I click on the double T here. I think I've been mentioning this in many of my tutorials. And bring this one over here. So let me make it 2021. Very simple. Then align center. All right, from here, so let me try to also align this one with this so that it will be straight. Kumasi Sports Stadium. Let me look at it again. So they use the same blue and make the text smaller again. Kumasi Sports Stadium. Heroes Park. So the Heroes Park is the main thing, so they try to throw more light over it. This one, reduce the spacing, reduce the size to 90. And we can get to put things up, even force us to resize it. Heroes Heroes Park from 6 PM to 9 PM. Then let's choose extra bold. And we are going to bring this one closer. Then after that, we align center. Align center. Make this one larger. Spacing is too much. 28. Okay. So this one is what we have also done over here. Alright, so from here, I think this one elevate the minor thing. So from here, grab your rectangle 2, I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and I have also realized that they had a stroke on it, so the stroke, they chose white. So let me delete this and increase the stroke to maybe 3 pixels. It's too small. Let's go for something bigger. 5. All right, so from here, I think there is 6 in number, so damn. All right, then from here, I'll hold down my shift key. Then on the move to, I'm going to select all of them. Select this, hold down the shift key, select all of them. Then I'm going to drag it down. So how much do we have now? We have 4. So 2 more to go. Yeah, so this was it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I think I should have brought it down. Then 1, 2. So these are the ministers. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 10 people. Wow. Let me copy. Alright, so there were 6 in numbers, so just select, I think they were 10 in numbers, so let's drag the last one and the other one. Let's bring the other person over here, so he's going to be centered. Then from here, what you need to do is that you select the image, or you select the picture, or you select. So what from here, what you need to do is that you just select the shape, the rectangle shape. Then you go to your document and you look for the image. So let me look for the first person. Who is that? The first image is who? And I'm really cool, yeah. And I'm really cool. Then we are going to bring and I'm really cool. Hey, where is this? Reduce the size of the image, and here too, we only want the picture. So, and what you are going to do from here is that you right click and create a gripping mask, and we want only the face, so you don't need to how should I say it, falsely bring much of the picture. Then I think daughters float, so I can copy this. Then resize this one, and I'm going to position this one over here. So let me reduce the opacity of this to see where it ends. Alright, so I think the position of this one is okay. So I will use my rectangle tool to make a selection around this. Then Ctrl J to make a duplicate, and I'll delete this one. Then I'll make the opacity full 100%. So you can see we are out from here. Let me delete this place because it shouldn't be included. All right so this is how it looks like. Then for me, I think Ankara took came, so Here is anchor 2. But before then, you select the ship before you bring the person in. Create a creeping mask. Easiest way you can create a creeping mask is to hold down your alt key, then you see and you bring the mouse in between the two layers that you want to crepe one to other, then click on it and it's going to be creeped for you. Alright, the next one, who is next? Dinah Hell Melting, then DSP. So here is Dinah. Bring the image over here. Okay. Then I'm going to crepe this, select the other one, DSP, I think DSP Kofi something something, DSP Kofi Sapon. Then I'll crepe this one also. And anytime you put images into boxes like this, please, the motive here is to see the face of the person. So make sure you increase the size of the image so that the face of the picture involved comes out as we want it to be. Alright, so from here, I think Hanama for Dinah Samoa. So Dinah Samoa, then Hanamafo picture. Hanamafo. And always spend time on your image to do editing, because you see these images, we need to do some changes, or you need to change the blending mode. So let's say when we pick levels, then we adjust the colors so that it's brightening up a bit. So let's see before, after. So this is the after, this is before, after. So if you don't take time and work on the image for it to look good, at the end of the day you are going to lose, because still you had a mistake in your work. So designing a poster is not an easy, designing a flyer is a very big task. But that is the path that we have chosen to go or be. So no matter how hard it is, I know anything in this world is very difficult to do. So when someone, or if you are a person that you like someone to do a design for you, please make sure you pay, because it's not a difficult, it's not an easy job. So designers too must also chop. I think Selena Boateng. Do I have this image? Selena. Selena. I don't think I have that one. But I think I am connected to the internet, so while I was searching, Celine. Oh, Celine Poitin picture. So let's choose this one. Copy. Then let's come and paste. Alright, so from here, I think what we have to do next is to add the names. And this is not easy. Hey, wow. So from here, you select your rectangle to then we draw a rectangle over this. We choose a color. Let's maintain the blue. Select the pen tool. Select the test tool and we will start typing the name. So let me reduce the size to maybe 15 and see. 15 is too much, so let's say 10. I think 10 will work. So this one is Elder Miracle. Elder Miwe. Elder Miracle. Then I will change the color to white. Let me see what I have typed. Is that how it's spelled? Yeah, I think I'm correct. Then from here, I'll change this one to capsule. Click on the double T. Let me leave the tracking to 0. Okay. Then I'll change from bold to maybe semi-bold because I don't want bold for this. Even regular is okay. So that the name can pop. Alright, so when it's centered, I can select both of them and I'll click on link layers. So it's the same thing. We will do the same thing for all the images, but I will leave the rest for you guys to complete. I think Daughters of Glorious Jesus. So D A G T Daughters of Glorious. Hey, how is Glorious Jesus? Alright, so I have selected both of them and I'll just quickly change the name to a new name, Ankratu. Then, so someone will ask me, how are you being able to copy fast? So what I do to copy is that it's very simple, it's very easy to do, nothing to worry about. Let me leave this one to maybe 8 because the name is too long. So what I do is that I select both the text and the name, then I hold down the shift or I hold down the alt key and I drag over it to make a duplicate. Let me see, I have the name over here. So And then I just bring the image. So the same thing, select both of them, hold down the Alt key, then I'll drag it, and whilst I am moving it, I hold down the Shift key so that it will be in straight line. Who was this? This is Hannah Mafo. Then I think Diana Samoa. All right, so you just take your time. So hopefully designing something which involves many people and many stuff like this. I think the last person was who? Selena Boateng, okay. Selena Boateng. So I think, and they also brought a shape at the top, and we don't want any stroke, but with the shape, Control T for free transform, right click, and this time around we'll choose perspective because we want to bring the perspective of the top. And you see how to get this, very simple to do. Then we can change the color of this one to red, and let's bring a text over here. So let me delete this one, and I'll change to me niche train. Then I can make this one larger, like 12, because it's very key. Let's leave it at 15. Align this to center. Alright, so this is how you can go about this simple design. Let me use random people for this one. Alright, so I'm going to use this nice looking ladies for this one. Alright, so I just want to quickly fill this for all of us. So you can see how very tough to do a design, and if the person doesn't pay, it really hurts, because Charlie, they think designing is simple or is a very easy something. So if you think it's very easy or you can do it yourself, why not? Charlie, if you think designing something is very easy, you don't need to pay for it, Charlie, do it yourself, because the annoying thing in designing is cutting around or removing background of images. And some people, those people who doesn't want to pay, will bring people like pastors, like Charlie, 10 pastors, all of them on the program, and you have to remove all of them, their background. Hey Charlie, and the person doesn't want to also pay. Even online too, when you just remove background for people, they will be paying you. So guys, in our next subsequent videos, I'll be showing you ways you can earn money, or you can do some side hustles to earn money with your graphic design, because the aim here of learning all this information is to help us get money. Without that, Charlie, what is the essence of even doing this? All right, so from here, I'll add a layer mask to this, and then I'm going to blend this image in. Yeah, then I can make this one larger, and from here to, you see that this one, there are a lot of space over here. Then let me bring this thing here. Oh, then alright, so this is how our design looks at the end of it all. This is my final project. And please, I will leave it, since you people made my day helping me to reach 1,000 subscribers. I'm going to leave this PSD file in the description box for you to download for free. And also, please, I will leave a link to my site where I have many templates that you can download some and to add it to your subsequent project that you are going to do. Like, it's an easy to edit template which you can edit them, then include it in your project. And please, it's not expensive. Just pay a little, like $5, to get a template well edited. You can just edit it and use it to do your project. So once again, I'm very, very grateful for the love and the support you have shown Pasolo since day one up to today. I'm very grateful, and I love you all people. And please continue following this channel, and greater rewards are going to come in the near future. And please make sure you continue watching these tutorials. It's going to change your design skills. It's going to help you improve wherever that you want to improve. And that's it all I got to say. But before we leave, Charlie, let's try to mock up this one and let's see how it turns out. So anytime that we design something, you try to portray it in a way that when it is printed out, how it's going to look, Charlie. So when I print this thing out, how is it going to look? So let's try to quickly go through and see. So first of all, let me save sample as an image. So I'll choose JPEG, and I think it was saved into desktop. So I'll quickly save this one into desktop. And then let me close this. So you see that this one, they have already mocked it up, and you see how good it looks. I won't close this. Let's see, is this a mock-up? All right, so this is a template. Do not close. All right, so I'll go to desktop, and then I see my 1K celebration design. Then I'll bring this one over here. I don't think this is it. This is the shape. So I'm opening the mockup file, then I'll delete what is in. I'll go and look for my design where I save the work. Then I will drag and drop this into Photoshop. Then I'll resize it to fit the canvas. So just drag to fit the canvas. So when it finished loading, click on close and accept yes. So we are going to look at how this one is going to turn out to be, whether we did a great job or not. So you can see this one, because we couldn't finish the design, we needed to add the names and stuff. So this is how the design turns out to be. Dry bone back to life. And Charlie, let's compare to their own. This is their own, and this is ours. So I'm assuring you guys that every month I'll pick a design that looks fine to me, and I will share my opinions. Like, we will go through together and see how to design that thing. All right, thank you very much for enjoying this video, joining me. Please make sure you leave a comment. Please, today dear, make sure you leave a comment, leave a congratulation message, and Charlie, let's start exploring more. And please also don't forget to hit me on WhatsApp to add you to the WhatsApp group that I'm talking about. And I think the number is 054454. So let me type it for you so that you guys would you see. So it's here, 054454596. And what color should I make this one so that you see? Okay, so this one there. All right, so you guys should WhatsApp me, and I'm going to add you to the group. All right, so WhatsApp me and I'm going to add you to the group. I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. Thank you very much for helping me reach 1K, and please continue to enjoy the good benefit from this channel, and let's hope to see more since we are alive. All right, thank you very much. See you in the next video. Bye for now. We love you. play. Stream. Your stream is to immediately.